In this video, you're going to be talking about juvenile inflammatory arthritis, or JIA, otherwise known as juvenile rheumatoid arthritis as well. Juvenile rheumatoid arthritis is rheumatoid arthritis in children. Though commonly rheumatoid arthritis is associated with adults, it is prevalent in children as well. In India, some of the reports show that 1.25 children out of 1,000 suffer from juvenile inflammatory or juvenile rheumatoid arthritis. Commonly, rheumatoid arthritis occurs in the second decade of life and predominates in women more than men. However, as I said earlier, it is quite prevalent among children as well, predominantly so in children of parents who suffer from regular rheumatoid arthritis. These children, the onset of the disease can be as early as a few months into birth, and a period up to adolescence is considered to be juvenile inflammatory or juvenile rheumatoid arthritis. All the features of rheumatoid arthritis in the adults are also present in rheumatoid arthritis in children. It is categorized, however, slightly differently. It is categorized into three subsections called as oligoarticular, polyarticular, and systemic. Oligoarticular refers to the number of joints that are affected being less, and polyarticular refers to multiple joints being affected, and systemic refers to arthritis, rheumatoid arthritis, that is not only affecting the joints but also the other soft tissues, like it could affect the heart, it could affect the skin, it could affect the renal tissue, as well as several other generalized tissues within the entire body. So the autoimmunity, which is the cause of rheumatoid arthritis or juvenile inflammatory arthritis as well, is not only affecting the joint but also the other tissues, of soft tissues or connective tissues that are there in the body. Very often it is manifested along with tenderness, pain, swelling and warmth in the joints, one or more as the case may be. Very often it is also associated with systemic symptoms like fever, rashes in the skin and so on and so forth. Children, they suffer from severe tenderness and pain in the affected joint and may not even be actually thriving. It can even happen that they, because of the symptomatic manifestations, they will not eat properly and will fail to thrive in the normal course if they are untreated. Modern medicine offers treatment for juvenile arthritis by way of temporarily giving pain relief through NSAIDs as well as through disease modifying drugs. Predominantly, steroids are used to suppress the immune system, which is responsible for the inflammation in juvenile rheumatoid arthritis or JIA. The concern is, however, because of the long duration that the treatment would be needed. Most parents are extremely worried about having to give very strong medicines to such small children, especially when it is a disease that is not suddenly going into complete cure. It's a chronic disease that tends to keep recurring again and again, and every subsequent attack is generally more powerful. So there is a huge concern about having to give very powerful and potentially not so safe medicines, especially for children who are really of such a small age. It is in this context that Ayurveda really has a huge solution to offer for children suffering from juvenile inflammatory arthritis or juvenile rheumatoid arthritis. Ayurveda understands this whole concept under a disease class called Vata Raktam or Vata Shonitam, along with a condition called Ama. Ama, when it is associated with Vata Raktam or Vata Shonita, is known as Ama Vata in some parts of the country and slightly differently in other parts of the country. However, the disease is characterized by the vitiation of Vata Rakta, which is blood, as well as Ama, which is toxins. The toxins that are produced intrinsically in the body are responsible for this inflammation and the symptoms that are arising in the case of juvenile inflammatory arthritis. Because the body's immune system is creating cytokines that are affecting the tissues, thinking that actually it is attacking a foreign body, the immune system is actually attacking the joint. So if this concept is very well understood in Ayurveda, and we have a wonderful treatment comprising of what we call as Ama Pachana. In the very initial stages where the quantum of Ama is not very high, when it is not systemic, when it is just localized and so on, mild interventions like taking some herbal medicines, supplying some external applications which are capable of relieving the inflammation and so on may be sufficient. But especially when there is a systemic manifestation of the disease, which happens in most of the cases, there is a need to subject the child to a proper course of panchakarma or detoxification. Ayurveda recommends vasti as one of the most effective treatments in relieving the causes of inflammation, and we are able to see that Ayurvedic intervention comprising of regular administration of vasti, especially vasti is one of the safest treatments to be given even from very very small children up to very very late stage in our life. This treatment we are seeing when we administer regularly is able to bring down the inflammatory markers. You find rapid reduction in ESR, in CRP and so on and so forth, which are the markers to show the level of inflammation that is happening due to juvenile inflammatory arthritis. So this sort of a treatment that Ayurveda is able to offer through extremely safe herbs and herbal products, as well as Ayurvedic interventions like vasti and dhanyamala dhara, is a process which we use as an anti-inflammatory external therapy where we pour some medicated liquids on the body and so on and so forth. At AVN Arogya, we offer the entire spectrum of Ayurvedic medicines, Ayurvedic therapies on outpatient basis as well as inpatients for children who suffer from juvenile arthritis or juvenile rheumatoid arthritis. And we are really very happy to note wonderful results in children who undergo these types of problems. Juvenile rheumatoid arthritis is you should not call it as a cure, even if the children become completely symptom free. Because once the immune system gets into this pattern, it always holds a memory and it can always come back. So there is always a need to even continue taking some medicines and also to ensure that other lifestyle is supportive to benefiting the immune system. For example, chronic stress is one of the most common causes that can again precipitate an immune attack. So it is very important that even if children are completely cured with our therapy, it may be important to modify lifestyle in such a manner that diet and your lifestyle is in congruence with the healing rather than something that triggers your immune system to again get into an attack mode. However, with this comprehensive approach, so at AVN Arogya, we offer a holistic sort of treatment which comprises of diet, certain lifestyle issues, we teach them yoga, we also offer them relaxation techniques that help them to be managing stress in a much more comprehensive manner, in addition to giving the whole range of Ayurvedic treatments comprising of herbs and herbal therapies which help to bring the disease into very good remission without the need to use powerful substances.
Go here to subscribe.